In contemplation, are we? Maybe I can help. Thank you. But I can't accept. No, thank you. I must attend to my flock. Good evening. Please, no more questions. I'm tired. I need the plenitudes of sleep, if you'll excuse me. A fine night to be indoors, cold as the dickens outside. Cold but clear. Clear as a bell, and the stars, oh, you should see a million stars in God's firmament. A congregation of light. The name's Trout. The Reverend Edgar Trout. I'm returning from a mission in Africa. To Sunapee, New Hampshire. Where we... I live. Emily, my wife. She's dead. Thank you. We had looked forward to this journey. But she died at Port Said. Though it was Nyasaland that killed her, the doctors, you know, never did find all the parasites. We've just ended a hymn sing in the second-class lounge. It's the Titanic's first Sunday afloat. For all those in peril on the sea. Tell me, are you religious? Do not forget God, and do not collude with the godless. There are many on this ship. Leland Trask, for example, a seer. A clairvoyant. He claims the most outrageous blasphemies. Remember, that which does not come from God is not of God. Well, good evening. Wait, before you leave, I was wondering, perhaps you'd care to make a donation to our mission in Nyasaland. Sorry to have bothered you. Perhaps another time. I am very happy. I shall call upon you tomorrow to discuss it. Just a minute. Calling on Miss Pringle? She has been invaluable this voyage. A pillar. Oh yes, we're very glad she's with us. Unlike the occultist Trask. Tempting the passengers with his occult mysteries. They say you met Trask. Be wary of him. Trask's a trickster. Take this card, a prayer card, from my own collection. So, you must like it, this section of the Titanic. Here, second class. You can get to Scotland Road from here. Do you know it? Scotland Road? Scotland Road runs the length of the ship, from stern to bow on E-deck. It allows the crew to get from one side to the other quickly. I could go to third class if I take the Scotland Road. But I don't believe in social mixing. No, it creates too much anxiety. A place for everyone, and everyone a place. Though some don't choose to see it that way. In the course of my ministrations, I've observed a gentleman from first class. A young German, among the steerage women. Most unnatural. I haven't said anything. I wouldn't want to upset the ladies. Especially Miss Pringle. She seems a fragile vessel. Behind me, through those doors. You expressed doubt about the importance of our work in Nyasaland. I wanted to speak with you again in hopes the Lord has helped you see the truth. You mentioned that you approved of our work at the mission in Nyasaland. I'd like to add your name to our list of financial backers. An auspicious honor, oh yes. I am very happy. Tomorrow we will discuss everything. There you are. I have evidence of a scandal. I have seen a first-class passenger, a Mr. Haydelitz, among the steerage class. He's been gambling with the crew and worse. I followed him into third class, on F-deck, where he visited the room of an unchaperoned young woman. I will speak to the authorities. Such behavior, it smacks of socialism and unrest. Why, I can't believe you'd endorse such activities. Yes, I'll watch everything down here. We really must talk about a contribution for the mission. God needs your help. I'm looking forward to talking with you about the mission. God needs your help. Thank you so much. I will call on you tomorrow. God has moved his mighty hand against the wicked. Gambling, lewdness, and a mixing of the classes are repaid with fire. You have heard the news? Young Haydelitz has gone to meet his maker. Or someone else, eh? We can only speculate, can't we? They say the electric bath has never malfunctioned before. Believe me, it wasn't the voltage, but the cleansing work of the Lord. Yes, I'm sorry. I realize that you were fond of the young man. Ah, lost in prayer. Perhaps I will join you. You were wanting something? It is late. Goodbye. In contemplation, are we? Maybe I can help. Excuse me, I am occupied. Yes. No. Exactly. That is wrong. Pardon me, Carlson. Hello. No time for anything but prayer now. Get ready. We're going to meet the Maker. I must assist with the boats. Pray. Shh. No more talk. She's sinking. Down we go. Down to Davy Jones' locker. God has declared the Titanic a ship of destiny. The dry land was made to rise from the water, and our little piece of dry land, this floating palace, shall be lowered back into its depths. Prepare. We're going to meet the Maker. You've not found a boat. It seems I shall not see Sunapee either. This is a test of faith, like the blood fluke infestations at the mission. Unspeakable things. The worms fell even the fittest. We prayed then too, after Mazan and the bearers fled into the bush. Though Emily did not escape God's plan. Tonight is another test. We shall brave the deluge like Noah and his family. Does anyone know how long the great flood raged? Do you know? Incorrect. But here's another question. Remember Paul's shipwreck? His fellow passengers were spared, but only if they declared their trust of God. They did so and were saved. Now, my question. To what city was Paul sailing? Jerusalem? Caesarea? Or Rome? You are wrong. Now, if you'll excuse me, we must prepare. Goodbye. Exactly. You are blessed with fortune. Share it with the less fortunate. The family's on the second-class stairwell.
Comfort Miss Limehouse. She is in the first-class lounge.
The boats are gone. All gone. It is the judgment hour. Please, I must confess everything. Nyasaland, the mission funds. Emily urged me to repent, to give back the money. But after 10 horrible years in Africa, in the highlands, and Emily dying, I could not. I kept the mission funds, stole them and sailed on the Titanic. I'm a sinner, and he shall judge me shortly. Prepare, we are on our way to meet the Maker. The Maker!